Hi everyone, I am just continuing with my previous video, like how to write a resultant formula, inclination formula, right? So we have seen one question figure and we have seen already how to resolve it into x and y components and sign convention for that particular figure. And we need to make the summation of horizontal forces and summation of vertical forces. Summation of horizontal forces, you can take it as summation of h or summation of f of x. And summation of vertical forces, you can take it as summation of f of y, okay? Together, if you want the resultant, you need to use the formula r is equal to root of summation of h square plus summation of v square. And the direction is given by tan alpha or tan theta is equal to summation of v by summation of h. This is how you need to find resultant force and alpha. So we shall see few numericals with respect to this topic. And the numerical one, like I'll be just seeing, observe this numerical. It is having x and y axis and it is having some four forces over here, okay? Sign convention we are taking with respect to the graph. So in this, you can observe 300 newton is a vertical force, but 200 newton, 300 newton, 350 newton is not a vertical or horizontal force. You need to classify it, right? You need to make FBD for this. Just resolve it into two components. For example, 200 newton, if you resolve, how you will get means f cos theta and f sin theta, right? F cos theta is nothing but 200 cos 30, right? And 200 sin 30. And for 300 newton, again you need to resolve. So if you resolve, see, this 45 degrees is with respect to y axis, okay? If it is with respect to x axis, you can take horizontal as cos theta and vertical as sin theta. But if the orientation is different, for example, the theta is with respect to y axis, means you need to change it, like vertical as cos and horizontal as sin, right? So the vertical will become 300 cos 45 and the horizontal will be 300 sin 45. It's nothing but the c, or even you can take this as c. 300 newton, how much degrees with respect to x axis, means 45 degrees. So you can take vertical as 300 sin 45 and horizontal as 300 cos 45. It's up to you, no issues. And the last one is 300 newton. Again, 300 newton is having a magnitude like 350 newton magnitude, and the inclination is 40 degree with respect to x axis. So again, if you just resolve over this, you will get 350 sin 40 and 350 cos 40, right? So the same FBD is drawn, and you first one you need to do is you need to make equilibrium equations. First one is summation of horizontal forces is equal to 0, or summation of vertical forces equal to 0, but you cannot make it 0 because we need the value of resultant force. That is, we have the formula root of summation of h square plus summation of v square. For that, we need to calculate summation of h and summation of v. Okay, horizontal sign is taken like this. The side is positive and another side is negative. And vertical facing topwards is positive and facing bottom is negative. Right, with respect to that, just assemble all the forces. See, now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 forces, right? Because one is a direct vertical force, other three are inclined forces. So with respect to the given sign, just assemble, arrange the equation and find r, okay? And for r, you need to find the alpha. So alpha is nothing but tan inverse of summation of v by summation of h. If you do it, you will get alpha, okay? So you have got for c, this h is in terms of negative, right? Negative means it lies in the negative quadrant side, and summation of v seems to be a positive, means upward. So it says, clearly it says that the resultant will, sure it will lie in the second quadrant. So second quadrant, at it will be having the inclination of like the value which we have got from the numerical, that is 57.583 degrees, right? So our resultant lies in the second quadrant with the angle of inclination of 57.58 degrees, okay? This is how you need to solve numericals. So in my next presentation, I will be explaining the other numericals for this module 1. Okay, thank you all. Hi everyone, now I am going to explain the next numerical. So in this numerical, So actually they have given a figure. It is having four coplanar forces. Coplanar means forces lying in the same plane. Okay. And it everything acts at particular point, means it's a concurrent force system, right? And everything is having magnitude, direction, you can see in this figure. And we need to determine the unknown force P. Okay, it is saying that see 200 newton force, 500 newton force, 200 newton force and P, these are the four forces. They have given 45 degrees for one force and 20 degrees for another force and like another force, and this 200 newton is exactly in the axis. So what you have to find is the fourth force P and its respective angle theta. So how to find this means, actually what we have to do means, first you find summation of horizontal forces and summation of vertical forces, right? As I said, if you find any inclined force like this, means it is having some degrees, means then immediately you need to resolve it into 200 cos like f, like one f should be made into two components, means fx and fy. Fx means f cos theta, fy means f sin theta. So 200 cos 45, 200 sin 45. Okay, so for this 500 newton, 500 sin 20 and 500 cos 20. Okay. And in the previous numerical only I have told how to take the sign, okay, with respect to the graph. With respect to that, just take the equation summation of h and summation of v, and you will be getting p cos theta is equal to some value and p sin theta is equal to some value, because see f is also, p is also a force. If you resolve, you will get p cos theta, p sin theta, right? So you have got two values. Now just square and add both these things, okay, then you will get p square into sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to some by adding both the things you will get some values, right? Sin square theta and cos square theta will become 1. So finally you will get p is equal to some values. So you have got some value. Now we have to find the theta. Okay, just divide this first and second equation. If you divide, you will get the value for tan theta, means theta is equal to tan inverse of this value, you will get some answer, right? So this is how you need to find the fourth force and even the angle. Okay, I have like some one more example. So you can see a triangle ABC. It is having a side of 40 mm and 30 mm. Okay, and three forces like 40 kilonewton force, 50 kilonewton force and 30 kilonewton force at the edges, you can see. Okay, there are three forces in this triangle. We need to find the resultant force. So how it is possible means, first we know we should check that whether all the forces are having angles correctly and or whether it is located in the axis, right? So this 40 kilonewton is a direct horizontal force and 50 kilonewton is a direct vertical force, but this 30 kilonewton seems to be an inclined force. Means you need to resolve it into 30 cos theta and 30 sin theta. Okay, you need to get the value of theta first. So tan theta is equal to 30 by 40. You will be getting, see how this 30 by 40 means, they have given the sides of the triangle, right? So this theta is nothing but this theta. So if you find the theta, you will get to know the theta of this particular force, right? After finding the theta, you can find the summation of horizontal forces and summation of vertical forces. Finally, if you just use the formula R is equal to root of summation of h square plus summation of v square, you will get the value of the resultant force, that is 35.78 kilonewton. So it has been found. So thank you all. I'll be continuing with numericals in my next session.